In this demonstration, we will use a UL6 250 UL Uniseal Altra to repair a 6mm 1/4 inch crown injury in a passenger tire. We will also highlight key points to remember when repairing a medium truck tire using the UL10 291 UL Uniseal Ultramax. These are the TECH repair materials and accessories available for this type of repair. Additional information about recommended tools is available in Chapter 7 of this DVD or in TECH Repair Manual RM4. During the inspection, locate and mark the damage on the outside, and then the inside of the tire with the tire crayon. Remove the penetrating object from the tire if present. Note the angle at which the object penetrated the tire. Now continue the inspection and probe for ply separation. If separation is found, the tire should be scrapped or sent to a full service repair facility. TECH's TRT-105 inspection tool enables the technician to precisely measure the size of the injury and the angle of the injury, minimizing the chance of enlarging the damaged area. Here we can see the injury has accepted the tool just below the second line. This calls for the use of a UL6 250 UL repair for a 6mm 1/4 inch injury. If the injury angle exceeds 25 degrees, a two-piece repair must be used. Extreme angles put excessive stress on the repair where the cap and the stem are attached. After removing the inspection tool, pre-clean a large area of the inner liner by applying TECH 704 Rub-O-Matic Rubber Cleaner. While the area is still moist, use a rubber scraper to remove contaminating substances. This process should be repeated 2 or 3 times to guarantee complete removal of contaminants, such as silicone mold lubricants used in the tire's manufacturing process. The important thing to remember is that the area must be cleaned. Center a 111TM repair template over the injury, and using a tire paint stick, trace around the edge of the template. This line will serve as a guide for mechanical buffing of the inner liner. Use of the template ensures that a large enough area will be buffed. Next, mechanically buff within the marked area using a low RPM buffer and an appropriate buffing wheel to achieve an RMA number 1 or number 2 buff texture. Do not exceed 5,000 RPM. If the speed of the air tool exceeds 5,000 RPM, scorching of the rubber surface will occur, which will greatly reduce the adhesion of the repair unit to the inner liner. Mechanical buffing ensures proper adhesion of the repair unit to the inner liner by creating a clean, textured surface. Use the appropriate size carbide cutter in a low-speed drill, maximum 1,200 RPM, to properly prepare the injury. The low-speed drill eliminates the possibility of scorching the rubber. Following the angle of the injury, cut from the inside using a clockwise rotation. Repeat this process a minimum of 3 times. Now, repeat this procedure 3 times from the outside of the tire to assure proper injury preparation. Because of the increased thickness and amount of steel in a radial truck tire, the injury should be drilled 5 times from each direction. Proper drilling with the appropriate size carbide cutter ensures complete damage removal while preventing future injury growth. Using a soft wire brush on a low RPM air tool, lightly buff from the right side of the prepared surface to the left side. You may need to repeat this process a second time to assure that all buffing dust and steel shavings are removed. Do not use a compressed airline for this procedure. The air may contain moisture and oil that will contaminate the buff surface. Vacuum all buffing dust and steel shavings from the tire. When using a brush for cleaning, avoid touching the buff surface with the vacuum. This will lead to contamination of the buff surface. Cement the injury from inside the tire using TECH 760 chemical vulcanizing fluid and a spiral cement tool with a clockwise rotation. This procedure should be repeated 3 to 5 times depending on the thickness of the tire. It's important to leave the cement tool in the injury as you proceed to the next step. Next, apply a thin, even coat of chemical vulcanizing fluid to the buff surface of the inner liner. Do not apply vulcanizing fluid to unprepared surfaces. This could lead to contamination of the repair area. Allow approximately 3 to 5 minutes to dry. Additional drying time is required in cold and humid climates. While the chemical vulcanizing fluid dries, remove the Uniseal Altra repair unit from its protective wrapping as shown, without touching the gray cushion gum. Touching the cushion gum will cause contamination that may lead to repair failure. Apply TECH 760 chemical vulcanizing fluid to the black tapered area of the stem only. This ensures proper lubrication to make the application of the repair unit easier. Make sure the tire beads are relaxed. Remove the spiral cement tool. Feed the wire of the Uniseal Altra into the injury from the inside of the tire. Next, grasp the wire on the outside of the tire with a pair of pliers and carefully begin to pull the Uniseal Altra into the injury from the inside of the tire. Pull until the repair unit seats against the inner liner. Do not overpull. This will cause dimpling and possible breakage of the stem. Once the Uniseal Altra is in place, press down the repair unit with your thumb. Now stitch the repair unit down from the center outward. This process removes any air which might be trapped between the repair unit and the inner liner of the tire. Exert firm pressure on the stitcher to maximize adhesion. Remove the blue poly. Thumb. And stitch the edges. Then repeat stitching in the opposite direction. Make sure to remove the clear protective covering from the repair. If you are repairing a tube type tire, cover the repair with TECH tire talc number 706 to prevent the repair unit from vulcanizing to the tube. When repairing a tubeless tire, coat the buffed area with TECH number 738 security coat. Security coat assures proper air retention by coating all of the overbuffed area. In a short time, security coat will turn black, indicating that it is completely dry. The tire can be remounted before security coat has completely dried. Next, go to the outside of the tire and cut off the Uniseal Altra stem approximately 1/8 inch, 3 millimeters above the tire's outer surface. The Uniseal Altra stem is now properly in place. The tire can now be returned to service. Uniseal Altra repairs assure a permanent leak-free repair that will give your customers many more safe, trouble-free miles.